Now, this is something I've been wanting to do for a while, and it's also something I've gotten several requests to do in some way, shape, or form. Basically, this is a new series where I'm gonna go through every character video by video and explain how to counter them in depth. Well, maybe every character. You kinda only need to buy COT to counter most supports, but we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. So to start this series off, I'm gonna be explaining how to counter Vivian. Vivian is the realm's newest damage dealer, and because Vivian is so new, a lot of people don't really know how to counter her yet. I've been seeing a lot of people calling her broken and OP like with every new character, but in all honesty, I've found that Vivian is a very easy character to counter and deal with once you know how. Vivian, for the most part, is all about standing in one spot and holding down the trigger, only ever moving when forced to. This makes Vivian a very one-dimensional character, probably the simplest one in the game. Now, since Vivian is so simple, she is also very simple to counter. Her playstyle reminds me a lot of Bastion from Overwatch, except a bit more mobile. They both also appear very overpowered when players are first exposed to them, but after some time, their weaknesses become very apparent. Vivian is only OP in the same way a character like Drogos, for example, would be, and that's if you ignore them or get none of their several counters on your team. I'll admit that Vivian is a lot more devastating when left alone than something like Drogos would be, but when you understand how to deal with her, she's also much less impactful than Drogos would be if you know how to deal with him. Pretty much every Vivian game I've played has been me holding down the trigger and farming kills and damage for free because people just leave me alone or try to fight me incorrectly. Vivian does have a lot of ammo and a lot of DPS, and if she's just left alone to fire it all off, then yeah, Vivian is gonna feel very overpowered. Now, when it comes to dealing with her, there are two things that are pretty effective, and those are long distance characters and AoE characters. Vivian herself has some pretty noticeable damage falloff. Her DPS isn't really effective if you keep your distance, so normally long distance characters like Shaolin or Strix would be pretty effective against a character like Vivian. They fight from distance, and with Vivian having no movement ability, it's easy for them to hit her. However, Vivian's barrier does make up for her lack of movement. The barrier is an effective defensive option for her. It allows her to take a few hits from long distance characters and get out of the way with no damage done to her. You could aim at her feet, but long distance characters normally have big projectiles, and since they're so big, they can clip on the barrier, giving you a much smaller hitbox to work with. Not to mention, Vivian could go ahead and block her feet with the environment. This leaves us with the AoE characters like Ashe, Bomb King, Drogos, Willow, Pip, and Eevee, which are very strong against Vivian. AoE characters don't really care about Vivian's barrier. Now, let's go through each of them. Ashe is a tank, so she's a big target for Vivian's damage, but her kit makes up for it. Being AoE, her projectiles can easily be fired at her feet, and they'll deal both damage to Vivian's barrier and Vivian herself at the same time. If Vivian has something blocking her feet, then Ashe can detonate her projectiles above Vivian, having the same effect. You just have to be at a set distance. There's also Shoulder Bash, which deals damage through the barrier since it's a melee. Landing it also isn't very difficult because Vivian has no movement ability. Bomb King can remotely detonate his bombs around Vivian's barrier, dealing damage to her and her barrier but with higher DPS than Ashe. Granted, it is a bit harder to do. His Grumpy Bomb also forces Vivian out of position, which is very threatening to a character with no movement because they won't be able to quickly get back into a safe position. Drogos can't remote detonate with his in hand, but he can with his fire spit, and if you're using combustible then you can displace her, which again is very threatening to a character that relies on positioning to be effective. He can also fly up above her and her barrier to rain damage down on her. With no movement, Vivian can't dodge a devastating fire spit salvo. Willow doesn't have remote detonation and can't fly into the air for more than a second without her ult, but her seedling can force Vivian out of position to expose her feet, then you can just fire at her feet again. Pip is probably the least effective of the AoE characters when it comes to dealing with Vivian. He can sorta get above her with Waitlist, but it can prove difficult. He's mostly only effective when Vivian isn't blocking her feet. The AoE characters are also very effective against another part of her kit, her ultimate. Her ultimate has been one of her big talking points in the community. It allows her to do massive DPS, possibly until she gets her ult again, or even past that. With her sentinels being so small, it can be difficult to hit and break them, and while they're up, it isn't easy to kill Vivian either to get rid of them that way. AoE characters, however, don't have a problem hitting your sentinels, because once they hit Vivian, the splash hits both of the sentinels, making it easy to break them while dealing damage to Vivian in the process. Now, you may have noticed I did leave out Eevee earlier because I wanted to talk about the flanks as a whole against Vivian, since flanks are made for dealing with problematic damage dealers. Vivian's personal barrier makes it impossible for most flanks to take her on, even if they catch her alone. As long as the Vivian is aware, then she could see a flank coming, pop up her barrier, and hipfire them down once they're close. Even Androxus, who has a ridiculous time to kill, can't melt through her barrier before Vivian forces him into reversal, and once he is in reversal, he's a sitting duck because he's not going to be able to another step away with low health before Vivian finishes him off. As far as the flank category goes, Eevee is the exception because Eevee is AoE, and also because Eevee can easily get above Vivian with Blink or Soar. You just have to kill Vivian before she forces you into Ice Block, because then you'll just get spammed down until you come out of it. Now, with Reprieve, you can possibly survive, but Wormhole and Over the Moon seem to be the more popular choices these days anyway. So those are the characters I'd say counter Vivian. There's also an item, Wrecker. We all know what Wrecker does. Now, I'll admit that buying Wrecker only for Vivian probably isn't too practical in some situations, but for the most part, there is always going to be another barrier on the enemy team besides hers anyway. As far as competitive goes, there will always be two tanks on a team, and only two tanks in the game don't have barriers, and you probably shouldn't be letting the enemy team draft those two together anyway. With there almost always being another barrier to accompany Vivian's on the enemy team, Wrecker is a good tool for giving non-counters a way of dealing with her. Earlier, I said long distance characters are good against her, but her barrier cuts their effectiveness down. While with Wrecker, that isn't really a thing. Vivian will only be able to block one hit from a Shaolin or Strix before having to hide or take direct damage. Okay, so that's it for Vivian's direct counters. Now, I do want to stress that those aren't the only ways to deal with her, they're just the easiest. For example, something like a Maeve could, in theory, deal with Vivian if she waits out the barrier or attacks during a moment when Vivian cannot direct her attention towards the Maeve. It's just you have to put a lot more thought and work into doing something like that, and it's risky because you need to have a situational advantage. While the counters I mentioned pretty much always have the advantage, and that's what I consider a counter, something that always has an advantage over something else. Hopefully this video helps a lot of you out so Vivian doesn't feel too overpowered. Again, I don't really think Vivian is all that overpowered. My favorite characters are mostly AoE, so I've been using counters against her from the start, but I understand that most of the community does not play Blast and they prefer direct damage. Now again, like I said earlier, this is a series, so there will be more. I picked the first character, and I want you guys to pick the rest of them. So in the comments, go ahead and let me know who you guys would like to see a How to Counter video on next. You can either comment the character's name, or if you see the character's name is already down there, you could leave a like on that comment, whatever works for you. And then in the next video, you guys can pick the third one, and so on, so on. And that's pretty much it, guys. I want to thank you all for watching. I very much appreciate it, and I'm going to see you guys laters. Bye!